Hey guys, my name is Alan Burton, and I'll be talking with you guys today about power and authority. When we look at the words power and authority, a lot of the times we may think that these words mean the same exact thing. Because power and authority kind of go hand in hand. If I got the power, I got the authority, and there's no way I got authority and no power. This is the things that run through people here, but actually, they are two things, they're synergized. They are two things working together to perform something, just like beginning and end works together to make a storyline. These things work together to produce action, to produce responsibility and an action. So authority just means the right to perform a task or give the orders to someone else. Whereas though power means the ability to get someone to do something, or the ability to do something yourself. So the power aspect of it means I have the ability to come in at work and clock in and do the things that I do to perform my daily task at work. But however, when a customer comes in and requests a certain amount of money on a refund, I have to go get the authority now, the person that has the right to make that decision. I just got the abilities to serve and to do things. I don't necessarily have the right to make certain decisions about that situation. Whereas though authority means that when we have the right to vote, we vote people in based off their ability to make laws, which is that makes them responsible, which responsibility means the obligation to perform assigned activities based on their ability, their power. So when we put people in office, they have the power, but we have the authority because we have the right to vote. They have the power to make laws, the power to start to vote on laws, the power to impeach. But it is us that has the authority, that we have the right to decide who's in office. That's the difference. But our right to vote and their power to make laws work together to give us a congregation, a government, as I would say. And, you know, I talked about responsibility. And the priority principle and management states that quality of being equal or equivalent, personnel must have equal amounts of authority and responsibility. So we cannot give people that that run for us the responsibility of making laws without giving them our authority. So that means they speak for us as if we were there. We give them the right to make decisions on us. So also saying, we hire somebody to lift 150 pounds. Well, that person cannot accept that obligation if they don't have the ability to lift 150 pounds. They're not responsible. So we cannot give them the authority because they don't have the ability to do it. But when we give them, when you have the ability to do something, you get the authority. The oldest sibling has the power, the ability. When the parent is left, when the parent is not there, when the siblings, younger siblings are left there, but it's the parent that gives them the authority. See, they now the younger siblings have to follow they have to follow the order of the older sibling because the older sibling is the responsible one. That's the one the parent left responsible for y'all when I'm gone. I'm not just giving you the power, the ability to watch them. I'm also making you responsible. So now you have rights to tell them, okay, it's time to go to bed. It's time to cut the lights off. You're acting as if you were the parent because now you have that authority. It was given to me. That's the difference between power and authority, but how they work in responsibility. They work in deciding who's obligated to perform a certain task. That's power and authority.